Hello and welcome to the first edition of Team Talk, the show where players and coaches sit down to discuss topics that influence how teams work. I'm your host, Adam Woolley, varsity baseball coach here at Lanphier High School, alongside Jacob Thomas, an athlete here at the high school. Today, we're set to talk about the topic of leadership from both the players' and coaches' perspective. Joining us on our show and representing the coach's point of view is first-year soccer coach Keith Jeffrey. And on the player's side, Brandon Holt. Brandon plays both soccer and baseball here at Lanphier and hockey at the AA travel level. But at this time, let me turn it over to Jacob Thomas to get the conversation going. Jacob?
Thanks, Mr. Woolley. Mr. Jeffrey, I want to ask you, what exactly do you look for when you're breaking down a leader or a team captain?
You know, first and foremost, you want to get someone who's dedicated, you know, who's familiar with your system, you know, who has good work ethic on and off the field, you know, who's holding himself at a high level, you know, as well in the classroom. And he comes in and the kids are working towards him. He's working towards goals. He's got set goals, realistic goals. And, you know, someone who's really trustworthy and honest.
So to piggyback off of that, too, when you're looking at a player's leader from a coach's standpoint, we also want somebody who's going to be able to have those players gravitate toward them. In other words, basically like having a second set of eyes on the field from that coaching perspective. So let me flip the script around a little bit to you guys and start off with you, Brandon. When you're looking for leadership out of players, peers that who you respect, what are you looking for? What do you want your player captain to embody?
The biggest thing I'd say is just bringing everyone together. It is like, it doesn't have to be the captain. It could really be anyone on the team. It's not a set person. It's just whoever like takes the responsibility, whoever steps up. It's like that person. It doesn't even have to be something big, but like could just be like, hey, let's focus up. Let's get this drill. Like if we mess it up a few times, it's like it's as simple as that. It doesn't really have to be something huge and like very noticeable. It can be something as small as just a few words or getting the drill started, getting something started. That's what I think one of the biggest things as a leader, what you could do.
So when we look at that, we're not talking necessarily about a person who is appointed by the coach, you know, because that can be a subjective thing too. You're looking, what I'm hearing from Brandon, Jacob, you can correct me if I'm wrong here, is that you're looking for somebody who the team looks toward, they respect.
So someone who can, mainly what I see this as, my perspective is someone who wants to take charge and will take charge.
Yeah.
You know, at any given time, if they need someone to step up, That's your player.
It's like you can count on that person like every time. Like that's like what your leader is.
So is the consistency more of an important characteristic versus like the rah-rah type of a guy? You're talking like consistent performance, consistent showing up. Is that what you mean?
I think consistent attitude and determination.
Okay.
Like he could be playing bad. He could have a bad game, bad practice. But I mean, if his attitude's still there and he's still like trying to get the team's attitude up, I think that's what the leader is. I don't think it's necessarily the performance, but it's more of an attitude.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
I mean, it's all right. But I feel that a leader definitely needs to bring positive energy to the team as well. You know, because if one person falls off, it's like a domino effect. And mainly, a leader's got to work to prevent that. I really think it's a big thing.
So these guys are talking. Both of them touched on attitude as something that's extremely important. What happens when you see this kind of thing permeate inside of your team, when you see a guy who's maybe his attentions are focused on his performance or his outcome, what do you see as a coach out of that perspective in a negative way?
Well, going back to attitude, I think something that's very important is body language. If you're a good leader, you always got to be positive in everything you do. Once you start getting that attitude sinking down, like Jacob said, it's a domino effect, and it's going to have an effect on everyone, and then that'll have an effect on the results at the end of the day. So, attitude and body language is huge.
I got to tell you something about, you're talking about body language and the way that you carry yourself on the field. Last night in the World Series, we were alluding before the show went on, talking about Chris Bryant and his leadership. He's a young player. He's got all kinds of veterans surrounding him and an incredibly experienced coach. But his play last night was one of the things that, brought up the entire team, And so it speaks to what you guys are talking about. And Brandon, working off of that, when you see players out there in the professional ranks, college ranks, even something here, give me examples of guys that you look at as that show those leaders, like real players.
First person that comes to mind for me is Jonathan Toews, captain of Chicago Blackhawks. I've read articles on him. Like, he's one of, if not the best captain that there is in pro sports. Like, he takes full responsibility for everything. It doesn't matter what it is. Like, and it's only negative. When it's positive, it's we. It's nothing like me. Yep. Like, everything's a team, but when it's negative, I've read he is, whenever there's a bad game as a team, he's the last one undressed, he's the last one out of the locker room, he's the last one to leave the place because he just feels like he let his team down. Mm. Like, even if it's a one goal game or up to like a five goal game, it doesn't matter the outcome, he feels like he let their team down if they didn't win.
In that realm, you know, he has to bear the responsibility. The ultimate example for me, you know, not only growing up, but even when into adulthood, was watching Steve Yzerman play. And, mm-hmm. you know, the sacrifices that he made, because he could have been an all-time leading scorer at yeah. any point. He could have done whatever he wanted in his career, but he sacrificed the me for the we to win the Stanley Cups, and the outcome was right there. How about you, Coach Jeffrey? When you're looking at coaching leadership, who are those people that you see set that example and tone at the coaching level?
I would say that one of the all-time greats is John Wooden, you know, famous UCLA basketball coach. You know, his biggest thing was to be successful, you know, top of the pyramid is showing good character. You know, a lot of coaches want to come in and they just want results, but they don't focus more on the process. You know, and John's a big believer that, you know, character is what drives the process, which will then give you the results. So I think John was a successful, great coach.
You know, I want to get back to the we over me point. You know, that's actually one point that, you know, my personal baseball organization, you know, pinpoints, is we over me as a team over, you know, an individual. But speaking of that topic, so when you're getting to leadership, say, for example, you had to step away from the field, do you see leadership in the hands of one player to, you know, have an effect on the whole team, or the whole team to come together as one to, you know, get the job done?
You know, I think that, you know, that's a good question. I think it's the overall team. You know, obviously you have your leaders there. Those are the eyes when I'm away from the field. But, you know, from day one, I let everyone know each player is accountable for their own actions. You know, if someone's not doing anything right. My captains, Brandon was one of them. He doesn't have to go in and get on the guy. You know, they should already know exactly what to be doing. And if not, someone else can step up. You know, I think everyone on the team's a leader. But there's just those certain ones that you know, lead by different examples.
And the way we want to set this format up in the show is to really kind of enlighten, hopefully watch, and having players watch this as well. It's like, we want the entire team to buy in. So if you have things like off-season workouts, if you have opportunities for captain's practices, it does. It becomes grinding, especially a guy like me, or even Coach Jeffrey to a certain degree, where we're in the classroom all the time saying the same things over and over again. It's like, we want the players to take over. We want them to be the ones who have the personal stake in it, because when your high school career is done, we will most likely be in the position that we are. You only get that little glimpse of opportunity to be able to do that, you know? And so, that's going to lead me to the last topic that we're going to talk about, which is this. What influence do you think the coach should have over that component? Should they be continually like grinding on you, gnawing at you, or is it something where you want to just see them give it to you one time and then, you know, kind of back off?
I think it definitely depends on the situation, but I would like to see them like give us what they want, like tell us what they want from us, and then we just kind of take over as a team.
Yep.
And like we build from it, like we take control. But say, like, there's going to be, like, situations where the coach is going to have to get on us and gnaw at us. Yep. But other than that, I think, like, he should try and just let us as a team come together and, like, conform as one, really.
Yeah. When you're operating in that aspect, I think that you're operating at the optimal level where people just kind of take over ownership, and I think that's a great thing. It is all the time that we have for today's show. Brandon Holt, I want to thank you for stopping by. Keith Jeffrey, thank you as well. We're going to pick this up next week. We're going to talk about sports specialization. For my co-host Jacob Thomas, I'm Adam Woolley. We'll see you next week on Team Talk.